This is the last part of the three-part series on AI buzzwords, and we continue with the transformer architecture. Looking at the original transformer architecture, which was used for translations, large language models only use the decoder part of the architecture. So what happens is the transformer turns all words into vectors, adds positional encodings, so where the word was in the sequence, calculates the context, so which words are important to attend to, and then decides which word should come next. With this self-attention mechanism, the transformer can capture dependencies between all words in a sequence, regardless of their position or distance. And that is huge, because language models in the past would always forget the beginning of a sequence when they reached the end, even if it held important context information. So by using self-attention and positional encodings, the transformer is able to process input sequences in parallel, making it a lot more efficient and enabling it to handle long-range dependencies in the data, and therefore can train on a lot more data than language models in the past. Additionally, transformers are trained using self-supervised learning. So they basically mask future words and use them as targets. And therefore they do not need expensive labeled data, but they can just train on large chunks of the internet, or thousands of books, or business data. And this is where foundation models get really important for businesses too, because they can not only support you with your daily tasks, but they can also improve decision making, analyze large data sets, help businesses understand market trends and customer behavior. They can support with content creation and with customer interaction, and therefore enhancing efficiency. We really have to make sure though that AI is being used ethically and responsibly. And therefore a lot of big companies, including SAP, as well as governments, already have very strong AI ethics guidelines in place. Now you know why foundation models are so impressive and why they revolutionized the field of natural language processing and generative AI. And the next time someone throws all these words around, you know them all. Let me know in the comments what other AI buzzwords you find confusing.